In this introduction to integration, we are going to consider 7 different parts. What is integration? Integral notation. Integral power rule. YC is added to integral result. Integration of constants. Indefinite integral and definite integral. Integration of 1 over x and other integral rules. Don't forget to check out other integration videos. Integration brings together components into a single system that functions as one. Integration opposes differentiation, at times called antiderivative or antiderivative. In this video, we are going to keep it simple. To understand one of the differences between differentiation and integration, consider a water tap and a tank. If water from the tap is flowing at the rate of 2x, simply known as the rate of flow, then the tank will increase in volume at the rate of x squared, which we are going to prove in subsequent application videos. Differentiation takes care of the flow, while integration takes care of the volume increment. For constant flow rate, the slope of the function is 1. In numerical integration, for example, midpoint rule, Simpson rule, and trapezoidal rule can be used to calculate irregular areas and volumes of components, which we are going to see in subsequent videos. Differentiation and integration complement each other in calculus in the applications of area and volume. In the determination of maximum rate, minimum and maximum heights and distances. Minimum and maximum velocity and acceleration. Even the rate at which medication can be given to a patient. Many aspects of integration depends on differentiation to complete solution. Next, integral notation. The symbol to instruct for the integration of a function is an elongated S, which symbolizes sum, that is, summing up all the differentiated parts. For example, each drop of water from this tap can be summed up to a volume of water in the tank. Subsequently, in biology, the sum of neuron signals with respect to time can determine the membrane potentials. When considering the nervous system components of the brain, spinal cord, nerves, and sensory receptors, double integration can be used when you need to integrate the result of an integrand. Next, integral power rule. This formula is usually applied to some basic functions. For example, using this formula, let's integrate 2x. This symbol is simply instructing us to apply integration, while the dx is pointing to the function which will be respected as we integrate. And here we are going to respect 2x, and we are going to add increment to the x. Next, in this function, the power of this x has a 1, because 2x is the same thing as 2x to the power of 1. Next, let's integrate. According to this rule, we are going to add 1 to the power. Power and the addition of 1 will come down to the denominator. Next, we are going to add c to our result. Next, these two will cancel out to these two, and this is our result. You can see that this integral and dx are just symbolic instructions. Let's integrate 2x squared. If you solve correctly according to the formula, this is our answer. Next, yc is added to integral result. Only one c must be added at the end of an integral result. The c simply means constant. This is the missing link discarded in differentiation. To understand why we need to add this c at the end of every integral result, let's differentiate this function. To find dy dx, we are going to apply differentiation power rule. Next, we are going to differentiate 3x to the power of 3. Next, this 3 at the power will come down, and this same 3 will minus 1 according to the power rule of differentiation. Next, differentiate a constant. When you differentiate a constant, it is 0. Hence, we can let it out, and our dy dx is 9x squared. Next, we're going to apply integral power rule to this result. That is, we are going to integrate 9x squared, and while doing that, we are going to respect x. Hence, this is just an instruction, just like the integral. When you apply the integral power rule, 3 here is 1 and 3 here is 3. You can see that our answer is the same as our differentiated function. Unfortunately, the constant discarded by differentiation is lost in integration. Hence, we are going to add c to take care of any constant discarded or disregarded by differentiation. Whenever you integrate a function, you must add c at the end of the result. It doesn't matter whether the lost constant is a minus, you must add a plus c to it. Next, integration of constants. Unlike differentiation, when you integrate a constant, here I need to respect x. Hence, my answer will be 2x. However, don't forget the missing link to complete the result. which is plus c. Next, we're going to integrate 2. Here we're going to respect y, and I will have 2y plus c. Next, we're going to integrate this constant a with respect to k, and we're going to have ak plus c. Next, we're going to integrate 3, a constant, here with respect to x, and we're going to have 3x plus c. Unlike differentiation that discards constant, integration embraces constant. Let's consider the difference between indefinite integral and definite integral. Definite integral usually have a starting point and the end point, and the final result will not have the plus c inclusive because it will cancel out. However, for indefinite integral, which do not have a beginning and an end point, the final result will always end with a plus c. In indefinite integral, our answer ends here. However, with definite integral, we still obtained the same result. However, we are going to start by inputting the upper part into this result. Wherever we see x, we are going to replace it with 3, which we have done here. Next, we are going to input 1 after we include a minus. And wherever we see x, we are going to input 1. Next, c minus c will cancel out, and we are left with 27 over 3 minus 1 over 3. And solving this carefully, our final answer is 26 over 3. And for indefinite integral, we can't go beyond this. Definite integral always have limits of integration. Graphically, you can define the difference between indefinite integral and definite integral. And for the limit of the integration, your b must always be greater than your a. Next, integration of 1 over x and other integral rules. The integration of 1 over x has a result that never changes, which is the natural log of x plus c, which is same as log x of base e plus c. The natural log of x is the same thing as log x of base e. Subsequently, if the x at the denominator has a power which is greater than 1, then we can rewrite this to be this. Both are the same, and we can integrate, and we can have our answer, and we can have this as our result. The x here is greater than 1, hence I can rewrite this to be this, and this is our result. Likewise, the x here is greater than 1. Because the x is power is greater than 1, I can rewrite this to become this, and this is our answer. You can further rearrange your final results. However, when considering the integral of 1 over x, because the highest power here is 1. Hence, you are not allowed to do this. It doesn't exist in integration. Because in integration, this becomes undefined. It does not exist. This is one big error, mistake, and confusion for beginners in integral calculus. Just remember that this does not exist. Erase it completely out of your application in integration. The integration of trigonometric functions is one major challenge for beginners in integral calculus. I will introduce different methods of integration in steps to comprehend when and how to apply these formulas. This is calculus. To locate all the videos, follow the link on the screen. I will see you in the next video.